Assalamu alaikum. My name is Shahid Ahmad. I have lived in the US from January 82. That's about 31 years. I was doing engineering, so I'd finished my undergraduate engineering degree back home in Pakistan. In January 82, I joined UB to do my graduate studies. I left behind my family, my friends, and my country. Just like any other immigrant, you face the challenge of trying to come to a country which has a different setup, different pace of life, different culture, and also being away from family, you're alone. So you have to do everything by yourself. I don't remember any particular difficulty. Difficulty may be trying to adapt to the weather, because I come from a city which is next to the ocean, warm and humid. Coming to a place in January which was freezing cold, so it took a while to get used to the weather. And the rest of the thing is learn a little bit of humbleness, because we back home we don't have a habit of saying thank you or sorry. So those the good qualities which is available, it took a while to pick up some of those. So I was active in the masjid, I was active in some of the dawah or interfaith. I was serving as a president of the ISNF. 9/11 happened, I was the president of Islamic Society. So first thing in the morning, I get a call from Brother Qazi that we gotta go at the town hall and we have to go and meet people because this is the time we need to keep our communication open. So we had meetings with people, we had meetings with newspapers, I went on TV interviews. There were TV interviews done in this building here. And you have to be careful in a sense that you are truthful what you're saying. And at the same time, you don't want whatever you said to be misquoted. So your answer has to be precise. After 9/11, we did fear a little bit of, some lone person can cause trouble. For that, we contacted the Amherst police and they were more than helpful. And I actually had armed guard in the back and front of the masjid for all Jummas and all big gatherings. It was, let's put it this way, the most pressure I have ever felt or stress, because you're representing a community and the community is under the gun for deeds of some people from the same religion which we have no link with. And not even, we don't have any, conceptual commonality with them. I mean, they are extremists, but it's very difficult to explain to people that extremists can happen in any religion. We did a lot of interfaith work. We went to churches, went to colleges. We actually sent an Islamic introduction video to almost a few hundred churches and schools around here. So at that point, whatever we could do with our resources, we did that. Our community, we try to be in ourselves, like, you know, you get 5 or 10 families, they move around together, they kind of have a picnic, or they will gather, have a dinner, talk a lot. But we don't really interact with the larger community. We somehow see, oh, we got 4 families, we can survive, we don't need it. It may be true, but you know, for the sake of your children, for the sake of Muslim community, you have to get out of that shells and be part of the larger community. I'm trying to be a Muslim, okay? Why do I say that? Yeah, I'm born Muslim, but the lot of characters and attributes of the Muslim needs a lot of time and effort to achieve. If you're a Muslim, you're supposed to be nice to everybody, and now you're supposed to be helping others. If those small things you do wherever you work, where you live, with your neighbors, your own community, that will go a long way in having a better reputation of Muslim. You don't have to say things to get the reputation. It's your action which will speak louder than your speech. I appreciate to be part of this community and appreciate every single Muslim who one way or other I've come across. And we hope and pray that our community continues to grow and become more active and become an important part of our larger community.